I'm Tom Miller. I am the dynamic shuttle, I'm sorry, the Dearborn dynamic shuttle expert lead. And I'm excited to share with you what our team has been able to accomplish this year. It's been a pretty exciting year. So we're at that moment now where we're transitioning from an experiment to a pilot. And it's been exciting. So Ford, as Erica was talking about, Ford has a shuttle service on campus today, and it's the perfect environment for the Ford mobility team to learn from and gain that in-house expertise. Because what we have is the Dearborn Shuttle Service today services 129 locations. They transport roughly 300 customers per day, which are Ford employees. They drive roughly 500,000 miles per year total. So it's not a small shuttle service. It's a decent shuttle service here.
How many employees? 300.
300 per day. So what we're able to do is pull this the Ford expertise together to build this platform in-house to develop this service and deploy it onto our shuttle service here on campus. So we have a mobile app that the employees will use to request a ride from one particular location to another. And then the platform will take that customer request and it will pick the shuttle that's best suited to meet that, you know, that customer's needs. The customer will take that offer, and they can look at it and say, okay, yes, I'm going to accept that offer, or no, I'm going to decline that offer. If they accept that offer, that gets scheduled onto the platform on the back end of our system. And then what the platform does is it manages the schedule for all 21 shuttles, which we're starting out with four shuttles, but the platform starts manages the schedule for all of those, and then it will send that schedule to the driver. And it will navigate that driver to the customers in the most efficient route in order to meet those customers' needs.
One quick question. Yeah. You said there's an offer, and if the person accepts, why would the person reject it, and how many, and what's the history of rejection?
So we're getting ready to launch the project right now, but if the time of the offer, if it gets a little too late, then the customer may choose, you know, an alternative method, right? So right now what the algorithm is going to do is that offer is going to assign the ride to a shuttle. That shuttle will have other passengers on that shuttle. It will put that passenger on that shuttle if it makes sense, you know, from an efficiency standpoint, and it doesn't push any of those passengers on that shuttle outside of their promise. Right. Okay. So the driver tablet, the platform will route that driver from one location to the other to meet those customers' needs in the most efficient manner possible. And what the driver can use this tablet for, too, here on campus, there's a lot of walk-up customers that will walk up and ask the driver for a ride to a particular point. What we're doing is we're routing all customer requests through our platform so the driver can select a add walk-up rider and submit a request for them on their behalf. Sometimes it may make sense to put that customer on that shuttle. Other times it may make sense to send a separate shuttle to pick that customer up. One may be going this way, the other one may be going the other way. And then that driver can use that interface to remove themselves temporarily from service. Either it's the end of their shift, they need a break, they have a flat tire. There are times where a driver's going to have to suspend themselves from service, and then that will tell the platform to stop assigning rides to that particular shuttle until the driver puts them back in service.
What mapping service are they using?
Here Maps.
Okay.
Okay. So we have a we have this platform that our team was able to build that we're going to use today or next week on our campus here, and it connects the customer to this platform to the shuttles. And what this really does is this gives the Ford Mobility team the flexibility going forward to really enhance the user experience from both the customer and the operations perspective of what it takes to run a shuttle service. So we did use a global team to develop this platform. So we have our rapid response team over in Ford iTech. They work on a lot of the front end development. We have our analytics team right here, and we're in the Regular Research and Innovation Center here, which is the building we're in. We have a lot of Java developers out in Rick Palo Alto that really built that platform up. And then we have John Abernathy in the UK that's been spending a lot of time and effort on studying what are those key aspects of dynamic service. So thank you. Standing along the back there are part of the team, so we have a couple shuttles.